Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. I am Shivam Vijay. Today in this video, I am going to describe and demonstrate about the 8086 microprocessor trainer kit. The trainer kit consists of LCD and USB type of microprocessor, and this basically works on the microprocessor 8086, which is the main CPU of this trainer kit. The 8086 microprocessor nowadays is very useful to understanding for the users and to get the better knowledge and understanding about the embedded systems through which are using in different electronics components. The whole setups and different components and items are provided, you can see on your screen right now, and we will now discuss all the items one by one and then followed with the practical. The order code for this microprocessor trainer kit is 43707, and this is the 8086 microprocessor trainer kit LCD and USB type. This is the user manual in which all the different and complete details about the microprocessor and the different sample programs and different commands to use the microprocessor are provided. All the detailed descriptions are given in the user manual. You can refer the user manual to do the experiments and to familiar with the kit properly. The trainer kit has a main power supply, which is a switch mode power supply, which gives you 5 volt, 12 volt minus, 12 volt positive and 30 volt DC. The connector is provided with this kit. This can be connected with the slot provided on the main unit. We are also offering USB cable to connect and communicate with the PC interfaces. Also, RS232 type D-pin, D-type 9-pin connector from female to female, and this is the 26-pin FRC connector and a 50-pin FRC connector to connect the other peripherals with this computer, with this microprocessor trainer kit, and this is the real-time connector for timer to communicate with this timer applications. The complete setup or the 8086 microprocessor trainer kit comes in a complete housing of a wooden box. Let us open the wooden box and see the inside of this microprocessor trainer kit. The complete setup is based and installed on a single PCB at which you can operate all the functions. We will describe all the different functions and the memory types of the CPU. And this can be easily interfaced with the PS2 type of keyboard, which can be easily functioned with 104 keys. And this can be connected with this connector provided on the trainer kit. Now, we are going to describe all the details about the trainer kit, followed with the practicals. The main CPU of this 8086 trainer kit is the based on Intel 8086 high performance CPU, which is operating at 8 MHz speed. The complete setup can be worked in local mode and serial mode both. There are two modes of operation, and this is the 40x2 LCD display module at which all the functions and different values commands can be operated. You can also have an optional socket in which you can connect a 8087 to NDP processor, which can be also programmed and configured to run with this type of coprocessor also. The memory and the monitor firmware in 27256 EP ROM is placed in the highest 64 KB bank, and 64 KB static RAM is powerful with the battery, which is a range of 3.5 volts, and this battery can consist to store the all RAM address and RAM values. And the keyboard and display interface are working with this 89C2051 keyboard display controller used for the keyboard display on the 40x2 LCD display. The serial interface is available through RS232 communication compatible with the 8251 USART along with 1488 and 1489 driver chips provided necessary signal for the interface. The signals are brought out on the 9-pin D-type MEL connector, which are provided at J5. The baud rate is 2400 for this system, which can be selected through the software. The timer, three channels of 16-bit timer and counter are provided using 8254 channel 0, which is used at baud rate generation. Channel 1 and channel 2 signal are brought out on 7-pin real-time connector J6 provided on the front panel. The interrupt controller 8259. Interrupt controller provides 8 prioritized interrupt levels. IRQ5 and IRQ7 are brought out on the 50-pin FRC connector on the J7 connector that can be used by the user, and the parallel IO interface by 28255 present on board, are out of which one used for the PIO cards and one for the printer interface. All are 48 lines 8255 available, brought out on the J1, J2 26 pin FRC connectors. So this was the overview of the 8086 microprocessor trainer. Now we are going to operate and describe the working on this trainer kit. So for this we have to first connect the power for powering on the circuit. This is the switch mode power supply with the connector. This can be easily connected like this. You have to connect the points provided on the left side properly by tilting the connector. And as you connect them, it will easily goes downwards, so the power terminals will be connected through the SMPS. Now we will on the kit, and this will gives the LCD display, which is the prompted with the Dyna 8086, which shows the 8086 is the main processor. You can also connect the PS2 IBM compatible keyboard on this keyboard connector like this, and this is the reset key on the front panel by which you can reset and self test is diagnosed automatically. Now we are going to describe some of the program and the commands described in the user manual, then we will follow the sample programming to explain how to use the 8086 microprocessor trainer. The user manual provided with this kit consists all the details about the command structure and different modes to operating. We are now using the kit in the local mode command, and local mode command description are also provided in the user manual. So this is the local mode command. You can study and practice all the different type of commands, how they be working and how you use the construct the programs to perform the different operations. These are the list of commands which are provided in the user manual. We'll start with the display command, then this is the edit command, copy memory command, fill memory, insert byte word, delete byte word, search byte word, and compare blocks, register, trace, go, hex to decimal, decimal to hex, load file and write file command, followed with the input from port, output from port, assemble and unassemble command. There are all the commands. Description of command one by one are given in the user manual with the example how to use the command. This is the syntax of display command here, which can be provide the display from starting address to end address of the byte memory or the memory locations. This is the example in which you can follow and practice the commands. This is the go command, which operates and executes the program which will be used in the further processes as well. And this is the input port command, and different commands are provided. So I will give you a brief description of different commands to program, how to program the sample programming in this. Edit command is also useful to edit the locations when we doing the programming section. So now we are going to start using the sample programs provided in the user manual. There are different types of programs in which the byte multiplication, word multiplication, pack BCD from ASCII, BCD from multiplication, BCD division, BCD subtraction, and different types of programs are provided to practice and to use the CPU 8086. We are going to start using first program, which is the byte multiplication. The program is provided in the user manual. The first program gives the demonstrate signed multiplication, and this program multiplies 2 bytes 80H and 40H, leaves the result in AX register. So we will write up this program from starting address 0100, and these are the opcodes. You can use the opcodes to write a program, or you can use the assembly language programming wherever you, whatever you want and whatever is suitable for you. I will explain the program with in both the type of language, how to write up the program, and then we execute the program and see the results. Now, for writing up the program, first we will press in the opcode mode, we will press E and space, then we will press the starting address at from where we have to enter the program, which is 0100, and now we'll press enter. This will reaches us to the starting address from where we have to enter the program. Now I am entering the opcodes which is given in the user manual, so we will start entering the opcodes, which is B0, and then we press enter. Then we will enter 80, which is our first element of byte multiplication, and then we enter B1 for the second element, and then we enter the 40. This is the first second element to be multiplied. Now we will enter F6, the next opcode, and then E9. Press enter again, and now we will press CC to end up the program. Now we have entered the program from starting address 0100 to end of the address, which is 0106, or you can use the 0107, which is the breakpoint here. Now we have entered the program and assigned the values on AL and CL register, and the result will be stored in the AX register as described in the upper description. Now we will press reset, so we will go to home screen. Now before execution we will press R to see the register value, what is the register value right now, and then we also see the register value after execution. Right now AX is 00 and rest of the register are also 00. Now we'll press again reset. Now we'll execute the program. For executing program we have to enter the program in the proper syntax. For this press G, press space 0:0100, which are starting address, and press comma again 0:0107, which is our ending address of the program. Now we'll press enter, and this will show us the break at 0:0107. Our program has been executed. Now we'll again check the values or the result, which is stored at the AX register. Now we'll press enter. Here you can see the multiplication register is stored at the AX value, which is earlier 00. After execution this value is E00, which is the byte multiplication of two words 80 and 40 as described in the program. Now for second sample program, now this program we will enter in the assembly language. The program says the program described at AAM instruction, which is the BCD adjustment after multiplication. The unpacked BCD values in AL and BH are multiplied together, and then the result in AX is converted back into the unpacked BCD form again. This is the program given in the user manual. We will enter the program from starting address 0100 in the assembly language for this time, and we will enter 5 and 9 for the decimal values or the BCD values, and the multiplication of 5 and 9, which is 45, should be stored in AX register. Now we will starting entering the program. So for entering the program in assembly language, we'll press A, and starting address from where we have to enter the program, and press enter. Now we will enter the program as described in the user manual as per the assembly language, which is MOV, the move command. The AL register should be moved 5, the value, and then press enter. We will enter move again, for the BH register, which is 09 value. And now we will multiply both. The command should be BH. Now the AAM command should be entered. Now we will end the program with integer 3 value. So our program has been done. Now before executing the program, we will see the register value. Before that, the AX register value is right now 00. All the rest of registers are also 00. Now we'll execute the program from starting address G. For this, G is the command. Now we'll enter the syntax properly. G 0100:0108, which is the ending address of our program. Now we'll press enter. The program has been executed. Now we will see the value and the result at AX register should be 0405, which is the BCD multiplication of 09 and 05 as we have provided the in the program. So this is how 8086 processor working for BCD multiplication and other programs. Now we'll again use and perform a simple subtraction program of BCD to find out the sample programming. For another sample program, we will now doing the BCD subtraction. So this program describes the AAS instruction, ASCII adjust for subtraction, and in this program we will enter the two values, which is 9 and 5, and the subtraction of this value, which is 4, should be stored at the AX register. Now we have entered program. We will enter program from starting address 0100 in the opcodes. So for this, you can use the opcode program as well. Press E, starting address of the program from where we have to enter the program. So B0 is already written. We need not to change. Again, now we have to enter the value 09. B3 should be the next opcode. 05 2A C3 3F at 106 location, and CC to enter the end of the program. Now before that, we will first check the register value right now, which is 00. Now we will execute the program from starting address 0100. Proper syntax should be mentioned to proper execution. 0107 is our ending address of the program. Press enter. Now we will again see the register's value at AX location is 4. So the subtraction of 9 and 5 that we have entered in the program is 4, which is located at AX register given in the user manual. So this is how we do the programming and different examples using 8086 microprocessor. In the user manual, all the different types of programming and different details are provided. You can refer the user manual for complete study of this trainer kit, which is 8086 trainer kit microprocessor. And while working with this kit, and if you find difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for any kind of support. Thank you.